guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about editing so that you can finish that novel. If that sounds good to you, then stick around. A few weeks back, I did a video on the 10 steps needed to self-publish your novel. In it, I mentioned that editing is one of those steps. So in today's video, I want to offer some tips on how to get your novel edited and all the steps that you might need to get to a finished product. But I do want to preface that I am not a professional editor and that I don't know all the steps. These are just my tips from what I've learned thus far. But if you are seeking professional help for editing, then I suggest that you seek out a professional editor so that they can guide you in the right direction when it comes to professional editing. You can do a fast read, you can do a line-by-line edit, or you can do a developmental edit. These are all things that your professional editor will do, but there's no reason why you can't adapt some of these things to your editing process so that you can make your novel strong before you hand it over to others who are going to start reading your novel. So the first thing I suggest is that you do a fast read. A fast read is usually done, in my opinion, right after you finish that first draft. You're like, this is good. I started the book. I finished the book. I've got all my points. This is good. That's where you're gonna go in and make sure that, you know, you've said everything that you wanted to say, that there are no typos, that you spelled the characters' names correctly, that perhaps that you got your point across as best as you can the way the novel is right now. Next, you can go back in and read your book again and do a line-by-line edit. I don't really know exactly all the details about a line-by-line edit, but basically you're going line-by-line and making sure that there are no grammar issues, that there are no misspellings, that there's punctuation, that you've said the sentence as clearly as possible so that your point gets across just right. Next, you can do a developmental edit, which that means that you are making sure that your characters and your story have fully been developed and that you have reached all the arcs with both the character and your story that you intended when you first started writing your novel. Once you've done all that and your story is as strong as you feel it is time to hand it over to the first group of people that are going to read your novel. For me, that is usually my critique partner. You can have one or two or three. I only have one, and that is my daughter, because she likes to read the genre in which I write. So I know that she will be brutally honest with me if I've written something that doesn't make sense, if the characters aren't fully developed, if the story doesn't make sense. I know that she's going to be really honest with me. She's not going to feel bad about anything. And I think that's what you need to look for when you are seeking a critique partner. You want someone who's going to be really honest with you, but you also want someone that is interested in the type of book that you're writing, because they may not get it. And that doesn't serve you or them or the process of getting your novel to the best it can be. So once you get your novel back from your critique partner, you make all the edits accordingly. You may not agree with everything they say, and that's perfectly fine. You don't have to, but just go in with an open mind. Make sure that you are listening, that you're not being closed-minded because you're so attached to your novel. Make sure that you listen clearly to the feedback that they're giving you. If it makes sense to you, then go ahead and edit your book based off their feedback. Once you're done editing the book based off your critique partner's feedback, you can give it back to them and see if they'll read it again and see if they have any more thoughts for you. If they do, go ahead and fix it. If they don't, that's perfect. That means you can move on to the next phase. This phase is optional. I don't think you need to have beta readers, but if you would like to get your novel in the hands of people that don't know you to get like maybe an objective feedback, then getting beta readers might be something you can look into. Beta readers are just a group basically of strangers that perhaps do know you a little bit based off your social media, and maybe you can put the word out there that you're looking for beta readers. You tell them that you've written a book, the genre, maybe the word count, what you expect from them as far as feedback, by when. You give them a summary of the book and see how many people sign up. And from there, you can select a group of people that you want to read your book in return for a honest feedback. You will also be giving them a copy of your manuscript, so you know, you got to make sure that you can trust the people that you're sending this your manuscript to, because not everyone out there has the best of intentions. So it's probably best that you send it to people that are already in your social media, that you probably interacted with once or twice before, that you actually are aware of. So when you send your manuscript to the beta readers and they give you back the feedback, it's a lot of work, because if you send it to 10 different beta readers, they're all gonna have thoughts, they're all gonna have their opinions, so there's gonna be a lot coming at you. So it's very important that you think clearly to what they're asking you. Don't get offended if they say something you don't like, and don't go changing your entire manuscript because one person thinks so. I think the thing that you need to look out for when you are in that phase of beta readers, look out for things that everybody is saying the same thing. So if they're telling you, this person sounds boring, this person sounds boring, this person sounds boring, then that might be something you should work on, because that means it's not just one person saying it, there's 10 people telling you the same thing. So those are the things that you need to look out for when you are in the beta reader process. The next step is probably the most exciting step, I guess. After you're done updating your novel based off the critique partner and the beta readers, it's time to send it to the professional editor. The professional editor is going to have her own thoughts and opinions. And again, going back to what I said at the beginning, you need to make sure that you have a clear understanding between you and the editor of what you're expecting from them, by when you're expecting it, and the money that you're going to pay them. So make sure that that's all out in the open at the start of your working relationship, so there are no discrepancies and there are no problems. I am really lucky because I have found a beautiful editor that I love working with, and I will probably work with her for the rest of my life because I'm really happy with the work that she does. So I think for my next novels, I'm going to probably ask for more editing than what I've asked for before, but I'm going to look into that and see what she can offer to me, and you know, work out all the things. But once you send it to your editor is going to go through your manuscript and they're going to fix all the things, you know, depending upon what you hire them for. And once you get that, then you get it back and you edit it, and you got to make sure that if you don't want to pay them again, or if you do include a second run through, that you negotiate that at the start of your contract with them. Because I know for me, once I get the feedback back from the editor and I'm working through my novel and I've already edited, I'm still not 100% sure that the novel is like ready to be published, because I make typos all the time. So I almost feel like I would want to do a second run through of your novel. So you get send it to your editor, you fix all the things that they recommend, and I recommend a second, send it back to them, make sure everything's good, and then it's time to go ahead and publish your book. But then you're not done yet. Before you actually publish your book to the world, you can take it to an extra, you can do an extra step and send ARCs, which are advanced reader copy. I did this for the first time with Between Us, and I was really glad that I did, because I had one ARC reader, and I'll shout her out right here, Timmy. She read the book, and while she was reading the ebook, she kept sending me all the things that she found that were typos. You know, sometimes I would add an extra A, or I would forget to close the quotes, and she was just helping me out with all that, and I was able to fix it. So I am so appreciative of her for helping me do that. So yeah, so those are the steps for editing. I hope you found this video helpful. Again, I am not a professional editor, but I did want to offer these tips in case you are getting close to that final product. If you did find it helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up, share it with all your writerly friends. Remember to subscribe on your way out, and I would love to hear your tip on editing. I'm always looking for tips when it comes to editing, so I would love for you to leave it in the comments below. And that is all I have for you guys this week. I'll see you again in a few days on a new video. Until then, stay safe.